As the Korean population is decreasing, the agriculture market is also shrinking. The situation is getting worse. Raise your hand if you are a farming migrant. For those who migrated for farming, have you ever seen people who succeeded after migration? None, right? Do you guys want some tips on how to be a successful farmer? It's simple. Don't spend money. That's why we opened a new hope for agriculture with ultra-low-cost farming method that can save extreme cost. Agriculture might be devastation for some people, but I think it's the only hope. I'm 55 years old now, and most of my friends are retired. What are they going to do for next 30 years? 30 years without a job must feel like hell. But if you are interested in agriculture after retirement, there is some shocking fact that you have to embrace. Do you think that agriculture technology that you are learning is based on very objective and scientific results? Do you think it's public technology made for public good? Absolutely not. So who dominates the agriculture technology? If you look closely, you'll see that agriculture technology is behind these huge companies. Most of the world agriculture experts rely on funding from these companies. And do you really think those experts will do research that will benefit you or for the corporations? So what is the goal of agriculture machine company? These companies fund and distribute research only to encourage farmers to use their machines. Chemical fertilizer companies support and research that inevitably leads farmers to use a lot of chemical fertilizers. The same applies to the chemical pesticide companies. So the technologies that we are currently learning is made by them, and that is for their own profit. So I jokingly say this to people, that if you want to be successful in farming, then don't read a lot of books to be good at farming. Don't get a lot of education. And don't go after an expert. Almost all agriculture instructors, even in Korea, are trained to sell something. But JADAM is going absolutely the opposite side of these companies' will. Since these companies lead agriculture technology, the use of a chemical pesticide, herbicide, and chemical fertilizers continue to increase worldwide. Most of agriculture technology institute in your area will never promote organic farming. While companies leading the agriculture technology, say if a professor studies a technology that uses less machineries, chemical pesticide, and chemical fertilizers, can this professor survive from the university? If so, he have to give up the research fund that he received from the corporations, and he will not be able to provide scholarship to his student. Then students will no longer be with the professors. This is the scariest reality that we are living in right now. As more and more chemicals are entering into the soil, soil pollution is getting into serious level. So ladies and gentlemen, we have to think that agriculture technology only exists for the benefits of the corporations. This is no longer an objective and scientific discipline. Sadly, farmer suicide rates are skyrocketing around the world. As we all know, Indian farmer suicide incident is very well known to people. Farmer suicide in Britain is also a very serious problem, and it is same truth with United States. The situation of current modern agriculture is very serious. So if you just accept it without having any question about agriculture technology, you'll end up doing high-cost consumer farming where you have to buy everything. This is the reason why I'm telling people not to read. Don't go after an expert. So let me tell you realistically, to earn money by doing farming, you need to be independent from the technology that is created by these corporations. Sounds difficult, isn't it? And I believe you'd imagine that this path is going to be a reckless challenge. But I'm here to tell you how the process should be. First, we all should go organic. The world has changed a lot. In the United States, there are also organic stores in countryside and even in Europe. But most of the government officials and researchers in Korea are arguing about that organic farming will not work. Soil and water pollutions are serious due to chemicals. Now even the glyphosate can be detected in our beer. Herbicides are found in American and European beer. Only our government announced that beer in Korea is not detected with herbicide, but there's something much more serious than that. The residue of chemical pesticide found in human blood. In United States, if the diagnosis of the patients are not so accurate, then patients are offered a pesticide residue detection test. It's a shocking fact. These are not just a problem for an adult, it's also a serious problem for children. This is the true reason why we all need to go organic farming. However, there is a technical reason why organic farming is not so popular. Existing conventional organic farming has a problem that it is expensive, technically difficult, and produces poor quality. That's the reason why farmers are also not willing to choose organic farming, because it's an adventure. And permitted eco-friendly pesticides are not even able to control powdery mildew and aphids. And this is the another reason why farmers can't choose organic farming if farmers cannot distribute products at higher price. However, we have completely solved the high cost problems and technical difficulties of existing organic farming. JADAM's natural pesticides can provide complete control over aphid and powdery mildew, which chemical pesticide can't even solve. And that too even with the things that made by yourself. If you are suspicious about natural pesticide, I suggest you to use it for aphid and powdery mildew. If you compare the effects of chemical pesticide and natural pesticide, you'll definitely see the difference.